Hi, I'm Andy, and in this video we're going to look at how the Dropbox in Desire to Learn works. So we're going to go to the Dropbox links in this class located on the black navigation bar. And on the Dropbox's main page you'll see a list of folders for the assignments that the instructor wants the students in this class to submit papers for. As you can see on the right here, the columns here will show you for each assignment the due date. They'll show you a link where you can view instructor feedback on your assignment. They'll show how many submissions you have in each folder, and a column will show you the grade for your assignment, okay? So let's look now at how to submit an assignment, and we're going to use this demo assignment down here to do that. Until the due date, you'll be able to click on the assignment heading and it'll open up the page where you can submit your assignment. Also notice, as you can see, that the instructors have the option to include attachments you can click on and view that are relevant to your assignment, so don't miss those. When you're ready to submit your assignment, go ahead and click on the link. Notice the attachment, the instructor attachment we saw on the last page, is also here on this page. So to submit your assignment, click on the Add a File button. And a window appears here where you can upload your document. To do that, click on the Upload button and you can select where you have your documents stored. So in the documents file or on the desktop or anywhere else you have it stored, you can search for your document and find it and upload it. And how you do that, I'm going to go to the document I want to upload and double click on it and it will upload. Now sometimes they don't upload as quickly as that one did. You may have to wait a little while, alright? Another way that you can upload is by dragging and dropping. So you can take an assignment, take a file, and just drag it in here and drop it, and that will also upload. Unfortunately though, if you're using Microsoft Explorer as your browser, the drag and drop function does not work. Any other browser it will, but in Explorer it won't, and so please know that. So once your document has been loaded, you can click on the Add button, and you'll also have the option to send your instructor a comment along with the assignment. Okay, so you use this dialog box and you can write anything you want. I chose to submit the second option. Okay, very good. So once you've got this all set and it's ready to go, your document's in there, you can hit the submit button and you're done. Okay, it's done. Now, as I mentioned earlier, once your instructor has graded your assignment, your score will appear here, and by clicking here you'll be taken to a page where you can click on this grade mark option in order to see your grade and see instructor feedback on your assignment. Okay, so you do that and takes you in to turn it in, and your instructor, there's a couple different views. If your instructor's not using Turnitin, it won't look exactly like this, but you can still see the feedback. Okay, so you can see comments instructors have posted on your paper. You can also, if the instructor has left audio feedback, there'll be a voice comment here. You can click on that and hear the audio feedback. If the instructor is using Turnitin, you can click here and you can get an originality report on your document. And if part of the assignment is to get peer reviews, you can also click here to get the feedback from your peers. Okay. So that covers the information I wanted to share about the Dropbox. And I hope it's useful, and I hope you have an experience using it in your class.